Your speech at the Hall of Fame event, it was just so heartfelt and so wonderful. And Nikki, you really lit up the internet that day when you thanked John.
And to John, thank you for teaching me a lot about this business and truly helping me find my fearless side.
All the fans online went crazy for that moment. What did you make of that huge reaction?
When you're in those moments at the Hall of Fame, you really look at your career and you're like, who was there who helped me a long way? And so much of the time people will talk about themselves. And for me, like, I look at my career and I know that wasn't just because of me. It was Brie, it was the Bella Army, it was the producers, all the people that believed in me. And John was a big part of that. He really helped me be that fearless side and showed me a part of that world that I never saw before. And I think just because you have breakups or whatever it may be, doesn't mean you can't like thank those people and just truly be so grateful for the help that they had.
Right. And you know, because I even text John like to thank him, because you know, you do, when you get inducted to the Hall of Fame, you want to start to reach out to people and thank them, because you're like, I got to the Hall of Fame because you're this part of this big puzzle that got completed. You're one of the pieces. And the one thing that, you know, I always give John Cena credit for, he was the guy who sat in a chair, watched the monitor the whole time, and you came back from your match, he'd give you advice. Like, he always cared about everyone's match and their work and how to help them improve. And I'll never forget that. And so I told them all the time. And also it was like their third wheel. It'd always be all three of us traveling all the time. So I was like the memories and how much you just always gave us great advice. Like, I'll never forget that. That's why we're here.
You know, seeing you at that event, your fans immediately take to social media. They're demanding the Bellas get back in the ring. And I see you guys working out a lot on social media. Are there conversations about making an official return to wrestling?
We definitely talk about it. You know, the one thing is that WWE brought the women's tag team title. And we're like, wait a second, how did the Bellas not have this on their resume? So it's so tempting, because we would love to go fight for the tag titles, because that's all we've ever been as a tag team. And I think another thing too is, now that Birdie's four, and we were talking about when the boys get a little older too, to have your kids watch you do what we used to do to get in that ring would be really special for us. I'll never forget the moment when I wrestled Stephanie McMahon at SummerSlam, and to see her three little girls, they're little at the time, their faces when we came back, they looked at their mom like she was a superhero. And I was like, I want that one day. I just thought that was the coolest thing. And so the Bellas are definitely going to make a comeback. We don't know exactly when, but we said we have one more run in us and we'd really love to do it.
Yeah, but we are starting, like, I know for me, like, definitely starting that preparation.
Yeah.
Like,
I want to train hard for it.
When we come back, I want to change my style in the ring a little bit, but I want to make a statement.
Right.
And so I realized that I have to start that now.
Now, this question is, it makes me giggle a little bit, because I know both of your boys are so young, but do you think that there is a future for them in the WWE? Are they showing any signs of maybe being one day a wrestler? Would you encourage that if that was their career choice?
So Buddy, a wrestler in the making.
He is for sure.
He's so strong. And it's funny, because when you change his diaper, he sometimes will put an armbar on you, and it makes Brian so proud. He's like, he already knows how to do an armbar. I'm like, well, it's in his blood. He's very fearless, and he just is strong. And anytime like he'll headbutt things, or like he'll pinch his fingers and he doesn't cry, he almost gets like mad that he pinched his fingers. And I look at him and I'm like, he's a wrestler in the making. Now we think Mateo on the other end, he looks like a dancer in the making.
I think my guess is Mateo is going to be a dancer and a soccer player, because he has fast feet. He moves his feet a lot. He
points his toes perfectly.
Yeah. And so he hasn't really shown me the aggressive wrestling feels yet. Okay. Personality-wise, he can be very stubborn.
Well, I mean, in wrestling, he could be, you know, the Fandango.
Right. Yeah, the Fandango. That's true.
So they could be attacking.
But I definitely seen him taking after his daddy a lot. And he already points his toes. And I'm sometimes you're doing better than Mama did it on her season of Dancing with the Stars. His toes are good.
No. Yeah, and he moves them perfectly.
Is this something that you and Brian encourage? Is this a career path that you'd want him to take?
No matter what, Birdie and Buddy will have some type of interest in wrestling just because of Brian and I. It makes me nervous, because you do see the injuries and, you know, how long you're on the road for. And, you know, it's a tough industry. But if it's whatever they want to do, I'm going to support. So if they want to be wrestlers, I'll support that. And there's a part of me And I don't know if it's because, like, as a woman, to see, like, my daughter, like, kind of follow in my footsteps kind of makes me, like, it gives me goosebumps. And I just would be proud because I'd be like, wow, she was really inspired by me. And that's really neat.
Sweet dreams are made of this. Who am I to disagree?
You've got this incredible collaboration with Kalugo. How did this come about, and why was this something that you two were like, we have to do this?
Nikki and I are very fashionable. We love fashion and we love being with our kids all the time. So we wanted to collaborate with Kalugo because we're obsessed with them, to kind of have this line that goes with our fashion, because I'm someone who will be holding my son and then have to fold up my stroller from the grocery store with one hand. And so we've made them that way. They can break down with one arm and then I just kick it right up and I throw it in my trunk and it's awesome. And then we also created just these amazing totes that, for me as a mom, not only do they have every compartment that is amazing for Mateo, Dada to the rescue, that's amazing for Mateo, but also for us mom.
Yeah.
Oh,
she says hi, Artem.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Artem. Artem, how proud are you of the Bellas and this amazing collaboration?
So, so proud. It's amazing. The product is great. Mateo loves it. We love to use it. So, it's a great thing.
Yeah, we do. I mean, it's everything that we are giving to everyone is what we all use in our lives every day. And so it's fun to share that with people. I think, you know, when you realize, like, wow, this really works, I want to share it with our Bella Army. Like, hey, moms, dads, like, this is actually an amazing product that we love.